Welcome back to another Logic Pro tip. And today I'm going to be talking about VCAs, which is something that's built into most DAWs, and it comes from the old days of mixing on large format consoles, where they had these voltage controlled amplifiers that you could use to control the volume of things. It wasn't the same as a channel, it was something a bit different. And it works in a similar way in the DAW. I didn't really use them until recently. I had the problem that I was trying to sort of come up with a solution for, which was figuring out when I put automation on tracks, I would sometimes need to change the volume of the whole song later before exporting the mix. And when there's automation on, it would just grab the track and pull it back to whatever the level of the automation was. And you can control that in Logic with the trim. You can see here, if I pull the trim up or down, nothing happens. Oh, there we go. It was all the way down as far as it could go. So that's what the trim does. Sometimes I don't want to have to do this. I don't even want to open the automation. I just want to be able to grab everything and turn it up or down. And that's what the VCA can do for me. So I've got this particular track going into a VCA, which is, you can see this track below it. The tracks or VCAs don't default to become tracks, but you can make them tracks, which I do. I think it's much easier to see what I'm doing. So for example, if I just play this, this has got its automation going. And if I go to the VCA that it's assigned to, I can turn it like all the way down or up. And the volume going up or down with the automation is maintained. So it's awesome if I need to, like, you know, go to the mixer and grab, highlight everything to turn the whole track up or down. I grab all the VCAs on the tracks that have automation. I can also see all the tracks that have automation very quickly by just like seeing all these purple things here. So that has automation, and this one, and this one, and this one. Because, you know, I forget what I'm doing sometimes as I add more and more complexity to something I'm doing. So the next thing I want to show you quickly is just how to make it, how to kind of do it. So let's see here. I'm just going to load a track. So this is just a blank track that's got four audio and four software instruments. And let's say, for example, on this particular one here, instrument one, we do some automation and whatever, there's nothing there to play anyway, but there's automation now. So if you go to the mixer, you can control click on it or right click and go create new VCA. And so you can see the VCA is right here now at the end. And if I go back to the arrange page, you can't see it. So you have to make it into a track by control clicking on the VCA now and going create track, and it put it here. It sometimes doesn't do that, but it put it right beside the track that it was assigned to. So you can see VCA 1 is where it's going. If there are more VCAs, you can pick them from the list. If you have a group of tracks like guitars or something, or a bunch of keyboards that you want to control with one volume fader, but not have them go through a bus or something, that's what you can do with this too. And something similar, this is the last thing I'll show you, is if you take these audio tracks, for example, and they create a track stack, and you do a folder stack instead of a summing stack. Now, here's this folder, and it is basically a VCA. So this volume fader here is for all these tracks that are going to sub one, and it's essentially doing the same thing. It's just, it doesn't, they don't call it a VCA, but it's got the same kind of benefits. So I hope you found this interesting and useful. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.